Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In this exciting video, we will learn how to seamlessly send, receive, and store images using the MQTT protocol. But before we begin, let's address two burning questions. Can we really use the MQTT protocol for sending and receiving images? The answer is a resounding yes. However, the next question is it recommended? Surprisingly, the answer is no, it's not. Now you might be wondering, why not? Let's explore the key challenges that make transmitting images over MQTT a less than ideal choice. Payload size. MQTT is optimized for small payload, not large files like images. Bandwidth considerations. Transferring images over MQTT can consume excessive bandwidth. Latency. MQTT's low latency design may be compromised when transmitting large images. Quality of service. Higher levels of quality of service in MQTT for large images can introduce additional overhead and latency. While MQTT might not be the optimal choice for image transfer due to its limitations in payload size and bandwidth considerations, don't lose hope just yet. You can still use MQTT to send images for personal use as long as you understand and accept these limitations. You can experiment with transmitting smaller images over MQTT in an ample network. However, for efficient and reliable image transfer, other protocols like HTTP or specialized image transfer protocols are more suitable. Our goal is crystal clear, to send and receive images using the MQTT protocol. In this video, we will demonstrate how to send and receive images through MQTT. Brace yourself as we walk you through creating an Android app using MIT App Inventor to select and send images, along with writing Python code for image transmission and reception. So let's see how we could send image using MQTT protocol. Our journey begins with connecting to an MQTT broker, followed by selecting or reading an image. Then we will convert the image into Base64 format. Base64 is a binary to text encoding scheme that is commonly used to represent binary data in text format. It is used to encode binary data such as images into a format that can be easily transmitted over text-based protocols or stored as text. Finally, we will publish the Base64 data to the desired topic for image transmission. Now, let's switch roles and become the recipient. We will connect to the MQTT broker, subscribe to the topic where the image is sent, and eagerly await its arrival. Once the messages arrive, we will extract the Base64 code, decode it, and voila, the image will be revealed. So let's get started and write Python code to send an image using MQTT protocol. We are in the Visual Studio Code window, and we have this image that we are going to publish. It is the logo of High Voltages. Talking about logo, make sure to subscribe High Voltages. Now I have created a file to write code for sending images using MQTT. First, let's import the necessary libraries. We will need the time module for adding delays, the Base64 module for encoding the image, and the PAHO MQTT module for MQTT functionality. You could check out my previous videos on MQTT and Python to learn more about these libraries. Now, let's set up the MQTT broker information. We will use the broker hivemq.com, which is a free broker with the default port 1883, and we will publish our image on the images topic. You can modify this according to your MQTT broker setup. Make sure to change the client ID. To establish an MQTT connection, we define the connect MQTT function. Inside this function, we set up the connection parameters and define the onConnect callback function, which will be called when the client successfully connects to the MQTT broker. In my previous video, in which I have explained how to use MQTT protocol in Python, I have explained all these things in very detail. You could check out previous videos. Now we will write a publish function, and in it we open the image file using the with statement. Logo.jpg is our file that we are going to publish, and now we will read the content of this image file and store it in the file content variable. Then we will use the Base64 function to convert the image content to a Base64 encoded format. This ensures that we can send the image as a string over MQTT. To publish the image, we will call the client.publish function, and we will pass the topic and the Base64 content as parameters. The client.publish function returns a result, which we will store in the result variable. We check the status of the message by accessing the result variable. If the status is 0, it means the message was sent successfully. Otherwise, we display a failure message. To control the flow of the program, we introduce a main function. Inside this function, we establish an MQTT connection using the connectMQTT function. And now, we will start the MQTT loop. We will then call the publish function to send the image. After a 5-second delay using time.sleep function, we stop the MQTT loop. And now, we will call our main function. And that's it. We have successfully written a Python script to send images over MQTT. Now let's test this. You could see message sent to topic images. Now let's write Python code for receiving image using MQTT protocol. Now we are writing code to receive image using MQTT. I have created a file and copied the same code from the other file, since the broker information and connect function remain same. Make sure to change this client ID. And now we will write code to subscribe to the topic and decode image. First, we will have a function called subscribe, which takes a MQTT client as a parameter. This function sets up the MQTT client to subscribe to a specific topic and defines a callback function for handling incoming messages. Inside the subscribe function, we have a nested function called onMessage. This function will be called whenever a new message is received. It takes parameters such as client, user data, and message, which provide information about the received message. Now, let's write code to process the received message. In this part, the code first decodes the payload of the received message from bytes to a string using the decode method. Then, it converts the string back to bytes by encoding it with ASCII using the encode ASCII method. Then, the resulting encoded image data is stored in the image variable. Next, the code generates a unique file name for the received image using the current date and time. This presents the file name that will be assigned to the image file. Now, let's explore how to store image. In this part, the code first opens a new file in binary write mode using the generated file name. It then decodes the image variable which contains the encoded image data using the base64 function from the base64 module. The decoded image data is returned to the file using the write method. Finally, the file is closed using the close method. Coming back to the subscribe function, after setting up the message handling function, the code proceeds to subscribe to a specified MQTT topic and assigns the onMessage function as the callback for incoming messages. Lastly, we have the main function. In the main function, we will first connect to the MQTT client by calling connectMQTT function. Then, we will call the subscribe function and pass the client as a parameter. Finally, we will call a forever loop so we can continuously process incoming messages. Now we will have to call the main function. Now let's run the code. And you see, we are successfully connected to the MQTT broker. And now let's run code to send image. And you will see the file is generated with the date time. So this is how you could send and receive images using Python and MQTT. Currently, I was using the same machine to run both scripts, but you can run these scripts in different machines and different locations to send image from one machine to another. And finally, we can use MIT App Inventor to make Android app and send image using MQTT. Okay, so we are in MIT App Inventor. And we will start by clicking on start new project, and we will give our project a name, and you will see a window like this. Now to use MQTT and base64, we will need two extra extensions. You can download the MQTT extension from this website. I will put the link in the description, and for base64 you could download it from here. So now let's download these two extensions. We have explored these extensions in my previous video, in which I made a tutorial about MIT App Inventor and MQTT. So now we will go down here and click on extension, and we will click on import extension, and this is for MQTT. We will import this extension, and then we will import the other base64 extension. Then we will have to drag these extensions into the mobile screen. and you will be able to see this extension in the components. And now we will click on MQTT extension and we will have to set our broker here. And we will have to set our client ID, the port is 1883, we are not using any password and username, so that's it. Now we will create a basic user interface. We will go into layout, we will drag this vertical arrangement, we will set the height to fill parent, width to fill parent, and now we will import some components. For example, we will need this image and we will need this image picker. We will change the name of this image picker to select image, and then we will get a button and we will change the button text to send and we will make it invisible. And we will create a label here, and for now we will keep it empty. So that is our user interface. Now we will go to blocks, and here we can program our Android application. So first thing, we will create a variable, we'll call it image, and I will set this to empty string. And then we will connect to MQTT broker. So I will click on this screen one and I will say when screen one initialize, then I'll go to this extension MQTT and I will call this function connect. I will set the clean session to false. So when our screen one will initialize, we will connect to MQTT broker. Then I will call this image picker. And I will call this function when image picker. We have already picked our image, so I will click on this image and we will set the image here and we will select selection of image picker, and then I will encode this image. So I will go here and I will call this function image to base64, and here we will select our image. So this function will convert our image into base64. So now we will go back to here and we will call a function that when the image is already converted to base64, we will set the variable image and we will get the base64 data and we will set it to the image variable, and then we will make our button visible. And we will set the label text to image ready to send. And now when button is clicked, we will call this MQTT function and we will publish the image. So for the topic, we are using the images topic, and message the variable image in which we have stored the base64 data. So that's it. Now we will build our application. So now the APK has been created. I will download this APK and then I will open this emulator and I will drag this APK here. It will be installed and our app is here. So now we will select our image and you could see the image here and it says image ready to send. And when I will click on send, you see the image has been added here. So that's how you can send image from Android to Python using MQTT. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe for more such videos. And I would love to hear your comments about this.